Flinderation Tunnel, Salem, West Virginia. Supposedly one of the most haunted locations in West Virginia known to man. Today, we're here to find out.
Fact or myth, we're here to find out.
Ghosts and no ghosts.
Today, I got Marcus with me and Dustin with me. Ghost extraordinaires. And we're gonna put. Thought I saw something.
At this time, I thought that I saw a shadow figure standing within the tunnel.
The view down here? Oh, nope, just Marcus's wife.
Before entering the tunnel, I conduct a quick military sweep of the entrance to ensure mine and my crew's safety.
If you look right here, it seems like there was some kind of seance of some sort summoning this bug right here. As you can see right here, this lettering states, "He watches." Pretty scary, I don't know what you think. And if you come down here a little further, you see right here this little green guy, third eye wide. He's always got an eye on people that are in here, so we're about to be super, super, super positive we're not messing anything up while we're in here. And if you look right here, there's graffiti stating FTP, fornicate with the police.
FTP is commonly used by individuals who can't obey simple laws.
So we're dealing with a hefty bunch of people in here. All right, this little opening right here is called an alcove. What it's for is, back whenever this is an operating train tunnel, if there are workers or some sort of, person in here for whatever reason, there was a train coming through, they would run in these little, this little indentation in the tunnel, and it would stop them from getting hit by the train. Keep something back, take me in frame. And this right here is a hole. Alcove. Looks like some old fencing. One of them they're trying to keep out or in.
Word has it, there's a graveyard above this tunnel. Will we get to speak with anybody in their final resting place?
Another rumor that haunts this train tunnel here is that there was a derailment while a train was traveling this tunnel, and a lot of people had passed away during that derailment.
Rumor has it, there were many people out here from the county and murdered.
While investigating inside the tunnel, we found evidence of paranormal presence.
Spirit beer?
Now, if you look right here, you'll see a little salamander native to the ghost tunnel.
While investigating this tunnel, my crew and I had several personal paranormal experiences. Dustin stated that it felt like someone had a firm grasp on his pocket. Could this be a spirit of an ex-prisoner? Marcus's pant zipper continuously came unzipped, and I had a hot, moist sensation on my earlobe as if someone was licking them. Could this have been a spirit of a prostitute that was traveling on the train that derailed?
All right, as you can see right now, we got a lot of light in this tunnel here. It's still daylight a little bit, but this right here is what we're seeing without the flashlights. Absolute blindness. All right, at this time, we're about middle ways in between the tunnel entrance and the tunnel exit here, and we're gonna do an EVP session. All right, go ahead and turn the lights out. All right, ghosts. This little red dot is my cell phone. It's recording. If you have anything to say, you can say it into this. We're gonna ask you a few questions. Is there anybody here with us tonight? If there's anybody here, give us a sign. Do you even vape, bro? At this time, if there's anybody here, knock on the wall or move something. You won't. I'm not too sure, but I'm pretty sure that EVP sesh was pretty successful.
After reviewing the EVP recordings, I found nothing was captured during the EVP session, almost as if this tunnel was not even haunted.
Another beer? Must be some alcoholic spirits in this tunnel.
It appears to me the ghosts around here really know how to party.
Paranormal cavities? Or just a greasy fat kid passing through?
Looks like somebody had to rehydrate after a long night of spirit drinking.
Class of 90. Is there some sort of a connection with the class of 90 in this tunnel? Or does the class of 90 still rest here?
We thoroughly enjoyed our investigation of the Flinderation Tunnel, but now it's time to wrap it up and set out on our long journey back home.
It appears that our journey in the Flinderation Tunnel has come to a screeching halt. Wild things happen here tonight, but as of right now, it's time for us to say bye to the spirits of Flinderation Tunnel.
Bye!
While walking the path from the Flinderation Tunnel back to our vehicle, Dustin and I experienced a blackout event, and we do not remember anything that happened. Fortunately enough, Marcus was able to capture it on camera. Here's what he had captured.
You guys gotta quit laughing.